The Edmonton Oilers, Connor McDavid, Leon Draisaitl, and a sweep in the first round of the playoffs last year. Mike Johnson does a lot of work for NHL Network and TSN. Johnny, I still can't believe the Oilers got swept by the Jets last year. I don't know. Is this the turning point for them? Is that the loss that you have to have in order to turn and play it forward and be better going ahead? I don't know. Or is this just part of the course for what the Oilers are at this point?
Wouldn't the loss to Chicago in the bubble have been the loss?
Yeah, I'd have done it too. Yeah.
I mean, I don't think I'm willing to say, they learned, never happen again. They're ready. We know what Edmonton is. There are a few certainties, right? We know they have two of the very best offensive players in the world, including the best player in the world, and Connor McDavid. Leon Draisaitl is not far behind. He is a legit kind of top five guy in the world. They can play together, be dominant. They can anchor two lines, still be really good. Their power play is going to be incredible, be 28, 30%, whatever it is. We know that. But we've known that before, Dan. So what's different? That's where I look at Edmonton. I'm like, what is different? And, yeah, I like Nugent Hopkins. He signed for long term. He got years. He took a little bit less money. He's a really good player. Zach Hyman seems to be a really smart fit. They bring him in from the Toronto Maple Leafs. They give him a big long-term contract to play with, likely with Connor McDavid. He's shown he can play with other great players in Austin Matthews, Mitch Marner, Tavares, Nylander, the rest of them. He's good defensively. He checks a lot of boxes. They need top six scoring wingers. They need help on their wing. He will bring that. Okay, so I have McDavid. I have Hyman. I have Nuge. I have Draisaitl. I'm still looking at, like, what is it? Kyler Yamamoto. Is Jesse Puljujarvi ready to take a big step? Below that, once again, their bottom six, who were outscored, outchanced, out everything when they played last year, are there significantly different? Like, I like Warren Fogle. Is he going to be a big difference maker? I like Derek Ryan. Take faceoff, crafty guy. Is he a big difference maker? The same questions remain. And I know Edmonton wanted to do a whole bunch this year, and they got a couple things done, but they were not able to do everything. And then the defense, same question marks. And Mike Smith is, a 40-year-old goaltender who had an awesome year. Can he stay healthy? Can he do it again? These are all questions they wanted to answer, and I'm not sure they did.
I mean, you keep doubling down with an aging goaltender. Eventually, it's going to bite you, right? And I'm not saying it bites them this season. They signed him to a 2-year deal, but he is an older goaltender. He's got a lot of experience, and Mike Smith doesn't have a ton of miles on him as a goaltender. He's got a lot of years on him.
Great, yeah. Athletic,
terrific athlete,
body to work with. He's in great shape. He doesn't look like a guy his age trying to play net.
Look, like you said, this is the McDavid and Draisaitl show still. I think we could throw Darnell Nurse into that as well. I think Darnell Nurse has proven he is a top defenseman, certainly a number one defenseman, and is going to be paid like one in the National Hockey League. So he belongs there. They got Duncan Keith and whatnot. But the questions, like you said, still remain. So do they scare you? If you're an opponent of the Edmonton Oilers, you're scared by Connor McDavid, no question about it. You're scared by Leon Draisaitl. And they alone on a single night can beat you. They alone on a single night can tear your team apart, and it doesn't matter what else the Edmonton Oilers do. But we're probably looking at the Edmonton Oilers and saying they should be a playoff team in the Pacific Division. Do they scare you enough to be a team that can be a scary playoff team in the Pacific Division? I'm not there.
They
not
don't
there with this team.
Not the way they're currently built.
Yeah.
And like, you're exactly right. On a night where those two guys go wild, the power play goes wild. Sometimes you got to tip your hat. Those guys are better than us. So they're going to get some games. They're going to win some games. Duncan Keith, Cody Ceci, Tyson Berry, Chris Russell. They all have elements of stuff that are okay. And, NHL players, but you put that all in behind Darnell Nurse and Evan Bouchard, who's trying to take a step forward, I guess. Mm-hmm. If those are their six defensemen, if you can somehow even come close to surviving or sawing off McDavid and Draisaitl, you have to think you're going to win that game almost all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Now, tying McDavid or Draisaitl is very difficult, but that's where the issue, Duncan Keith, who's a Hall of Fame player, I'm curious to see out of Chicago, where they were not a good defensive team, where he won't be asked to be the number one guy, will he be able to get back, not to what he was, of course not, but to just better? An adequate second pair defenseman that can hold his own. If he can, that's a very significant development. I hope he can.
He has a lot of miles on him. That's a guy with a ton of miles on him. But I like that addition to this team, because they need somebody with the perspective of a Duncan Keith. And I think that will help. And look, you've got, look, Connor's going to be motivated. We know that. We know Leon's going to move, but you need, they just need more from some of these guys. And I think Duncan Keith is a guy where for him, less could be more, like you were saying.
Yeah.
But also the point being that he's been there and done that a number of times. Guys can look at him and say, what about this? Can ask questions. Hey, Dunk, you've been here before. That has to play a role, right? That has to matter, especially for a team that has to have the hunger after getting swept by the Jets and losing to Chicago the previous year.
I guess. I mean, it might be a stretch.
I don't know.
Yeah. It sounds good in theory, but I'm like, I don't know. I've played on teams and there's been veteran guys, and, you know, Claude Lemieux played with me in Arizona. We went to the playoffs. I didn't go up to Pep and be like, hey, we're down 2-1. What do we do here? And he didn't have a big speech to let us know what to do. Like, you know, experience is great, and it's great to accumulate it and have other guys around. And there are some, you know, difference making leaders that can do that. And Duncan Keith might be one of those guys, but I look at their roster. Don't tell me, right? Connor McDavid hasn't played in big games. Leon Draisaitl hasn't played in big games. Mike Smith doesn't know what it's like. Maybe, you know, Nugent Hopkins internationally, whatever it is, they've all played. So I mean, I never won a cup, so maybe I'm protecting myself. Like, you know, I don't know if, you know, this pearls of wisdom that'll come out of any cup winning experienced great player are enough to elevate everyone so that next time they get in the playoffs, there's no chance that they would get upset again or lose in the first round because Duncan Keith's there to tell them how to prepare for the first or second game or what it's like when you're down 3-1, just because that's not how, in my experience, it's gone.
That's not how it works. So playoff team though, yes or no?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Again, division weak. Division. There is lots of opportunity there. And I think the two guys up top, as long as Mike Smith stays healthy and we knock on wood for him and plays relatively well, they're going to be, I think they're going to be fine. They're going to make the playoffs and it's not going to be like a huge struggle to get there.
Yeah, I think they get in the playoffs. And then to me, it's a matter of what happens as the season progresses, additions that are made, they find some holes that they have, soft areas that they have. Can they address those in season? They didn't address everything they wanted to, like you said, in the off season. So can they address them during the season, right? I mean, that's going to be one of the biggest factors
for this team. I would not expect this team, if they make the playoffs, when they make the playoffs, to look the same way it does on opening night. Yeah. I think there'll be additions and other bodies in there, and they will be better and deeper because the same problem, they got to get deeper.
They have to, no question about it, if they want to make a run in the playoff. Johnny, thanks a lot.